It's the Norn Show. The Norn Show. It's the Norn Show.
Hey Coda, do you know what next Thursday is?
Is it National Pancake Day?
No. Well, we should check on that. But next Thursday is Earth Day.
Aw, we love the Earth.
It is our planet.
We love the Earth.
It is our home.
Such a bop.
Musical genius.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
This week begins the annual Muslim Ramadan observance, and Ms. Rowe gave us an opportunity to learn a little bit more about it. Here she is with Leah.
Hey guys, I'm here with Mrs. Rowe, and we're going to talk about Ramadan. So what is this in celebration of?
So Ramadan it's the holiest month of the Muslim calendar, and it celebrates over the course of 28 to 29 days where the Prophet Muhammad had the Quran, which is our holy book, revealed to him by the Archangel Gabriel in English.
Can you tell me about the fasting?
Sure. So because Muslims follow a lunar calendar, the day starts in the evening, but we fast from sunrise to sundown. So this month it's about from 4:30 a.m. to about 8:30 at night. And there is no food or water throughout the whole day. But there are also other restrictions, like you can't lose your temper, you can't show excess like emotion of any kind. And the idea is to be calm and collected throughout the whole day.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Juniors and seniors interested in a volunteer opportunity should apply to serve as a volunteer tutor for the MCCSC Cross-Age Tutoring Program. The MCCSC Cross-Age Tutoring Program serves 3rd and 7th grade students in the subjects of English Language Arts and Math. Students can use a tutoring experience to fulfill bucket number 2 of the graduation pathways requirement. To apply, students must be a high school junior or senior, have a 3.0 GPA, be in good behavior standing, and be able to provide online tutoring instruction in 3rd grade English Language Arts or 7th grade Math. More information about this opportunity can be found in your Canvas messages.
BHS and Performing Arts will be producing a musical review this spring. Auditions are open to everyone and can be accessed by clicking this link in the description. The review will take place in the auditorium the weekend of May 7th and will consist of a collection of songs and scenes ranging from individual performances to full ensemble numbers. Students will be masked and socially distant at all times. If you have any questions, please contact Mr. Steckbeck or Ms. Hugg. Seniors, it's time to submit your senior quote to the yearbook. Check the Class of 2021 Canvas announcements for the details, especially the deadline, which is May 7th. Yearbooks can be pre-ordered at www.yearbookordercenter.com using school code 3162. Cash and checks work too. Deliver $65 or a check made payable to BHS and Yearbook to Mr. Beaver in room 709, or leave payment in the main office. North Yearbooks are delivered to the building in August. And good news, seniors, you're having a commencement ceremony this year on Saturday, June 5th. Check the Class of 2021 Canvas announcement for details.
Do you think you know a lot about mental health? Come test your knowledge by participating in the Mental Health Trivia Challenge on Wednesday, April 28th at 3 p.m. in room 403. Prizes for first, second, and third place winners. Online students, email Ms. Olski at the address on your screen for more information and the Teams link. Ms. Ken and Sisters Who Care held a spring party on Wednesday. Students enjoyed pizza and other snacks while participating in group activities. Here's a look.
I'm Joey and we're having a meeting.
What's your meeting about?
Life. things that are on our minds.
Have you found any answers yet?
Somewhat.
Good. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Joey.
You're welcome.
As you know, Northstock is coming up this year, and you can help support this effort with some stickers. Follow the QR code on your screen or the link in the description to purchase some custom stickers commemorating this year's Northstock. Kirkwood Photo Lab has a new product to offer us Cougars, yard signs to celebrate your graduation. They are $25 each with no minimum purchase. Kirkwood Photo Lab contact information is in the description.
Hey, my name is Micah. Welcome back to week 3 of Autism Acceptance Month. This week we are discussing shutdowns and meltdowns. What are they? Well, they are a fight or flight response triggered most often by sensory overload. Overload occurs when an autistic brain is bombarded by overwhelming sensory experiences. Because the brain cannot process these senses, it cannot endure the situation and must make a flight or fight decision. Meltdowns can be thought of as the fight response, and shutdowns can be thought of as the flight response. Both of these experiences are extremely unpleasant for the autistic person, and it is largely out of their control. Thanks for listening. I will see you next week on week 4 of Autism Acceptance Month.
Hey, I'm LaShawn. Welcome to Reactions with LaShawn. I'm here with Leo and Jeremy Jackson. Tell me a little bit about your song.
So this song, it's a nice song. I'm sure you've heard of it before, but it's called Life Could Be a Dream.
Okay.
Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do 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 shaboom. Life could be a dream. Shaboom. If I could take you up in paradise up above.
Okay, you like that?
Me, I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and open, we'll meet again, boom. Ding-dong, ding-dong, a-lang-a-lang-a-lang. Oh, pip, I've spent my whole life loving you. Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Every time I look at you, something is all right.
Yeah, it's not quite the common style, but it's a beautiful piece from its time.
Oh, life could be a dream. Shaboom, if I could take you up in paradise up above.
If you haven't heard ad-libs like that before.
Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
I see you're grooving.
Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do, 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 shaboo.
So, what do you guys think about that?
Yeah, I've heard the song before. You know, I liked it. What do you think, Leo?
I like it. It's actually one of my favorite songs, and it's like really nostalgic, so I like it.
Yeah, it's quite a classic. I believe it's used in Cars 2.
Mm-hmm. So yeah.
For one of the scenes there, which is pretty nice.
Okay, well, we'll see y'all next time.
Here's your lunch menu for the next 5 days, starting with today when we'll have chicken nuggets, mac and cheese, mixed veggies, and a garden salad. On Monday the 19th, we'll enjoy rotini with meat sauce, Italian blend vegetables, a breadstick, and a garden salad. Then Tuesday, we'll have a drumstick with a corn wheat roll and a garden salad. Wednesday the 22nd is a grilled cheese sandwich, tomato bisque, and grapes for lunch. And on Thursday the 22nd, enjoy a Salisbury steak with brown gravy, mashed potatoes, roasted broccoli with Parmesan, and a 3-cheese calzone.
Hi, I'm Alexandra Shirley, and welcome back to the Northside Press Box. These past 2 weeks have been busy with baseball, softball, track and field, boys golf, and girls tennis opening up their seasons. Baseball played their first game on Saturday, April 3rd, falling to Northview 4-0, and then losing to Shackamack 12-7. That same day, girls tennis had their first match of the season, losing to Castle 4-1. Boys golf got fifth at the Seymour Invite on that Saturday too. Softball defeated Eastern Green 12-5 on April 5th, and on April 7th, baseball beat Linton in a close game 5-4. Softball fell to Jennings County 5-16 in a tough game last Tuesday, and baseball was defeated in a game against Lawrence North 2-12 last Thursday. Softball crushed White River Valley 13-0 in a great game Tuesday night, and girls tennis beat Bedford North Lawrence 5-0. On Wednesday, girls tennis defeated Columbus East 5-0, and Unified Track won their meet 139-53. Great job, athletes. And now here's Matt talking track, softball, and lacrosse, and maybe a little trash, too.
Here with first-year lacrosse player Judson Garvin. Judson, how are we doing today?
Doing good. How are you, Matt?
I'm great. Judson, what's your favorite part about the lacrosse practice?
I just like being there with my friends. It's fun to learn a new sport and pass the ball around. It's a good time.
Yeah, and Jed, what position do you play on the lacrosse team?
I play defense right now, but it's my first year, so I might get moved around. I'm not sure.
It's always good to be flexible. And finally, Jed, if me and you picked up the boxing gloves, who do you think would win in a five-round match?
I'd knock him out with a jab.
He'd knock me out with a jab. Ladies and gentlemen, Jed Garvin.
Here with God-tier lacrosse player, Ryan Hunt. Ryan? How are we doing today?
Fantastic.
And Ryan, what position do you play in lacrosse?
I am a long stick midfielder in lacrosse.
And what do they do?
I play defense.
He plays defense. And Ryan, what's the pregame meal to ensure success?
Usually just whatever my mom makes, maybe a little bit of pasta.
A little bit of pasta in there. And Ryan, how many games are we going to win for the lacrosse team this year?
We're planning on winning every game this year.
Every single game. Ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Hunt.
Here with sophomore softball star, Natalie Burns. Natalie, how are we doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. Natalie, how long have you played softball for?
I've played since I was about 8 years old.
8 years old. Wow. And I understand you guys have a new field. Are you excited about that?
Yeah, it's really nice.
Yes. New fields mean happier players. And Natalie, I'm going to ask you, what do you think your record's going to be this year for the softball team?
19-0.
Heard it here first. Natalie Burns, call on the season. Here with tremendous track and field athlete, Mason Childers. Mason, how are we doing today?
I'm doing terrific. How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great. Mason, I understand you are a very good track and field athlete. What events do you compete in?
The 400 and 800 mainly.
And do you like those races?
I love them.
He loves them. And I understand you're going to a D1 college for track and field. Where is that at?
Yes, sir. I'm going to Dartmouth College.
Ivy League school. Smart boy over here. Where did I cut you off?
No, I was just going to say it was in New Hampshire. But
New Hampshire, Northeast. And last question. What is the key to being the fastest Mason Childers on the track and field team?
You just got to be willing to put in that work, you know?
I put in that work.
He puts in that work. All you other Mason Childers, listen up. Maybe you could learn something.
Now for the upcoming games. This Saturday, boys baseball competes against Martinsville at home, and then they have a game next Tuesday against Terre Haute North away. Boys golf has a match against Cardinal Ritter this Saturday away, and a match against Edgewood on the 22nd. Softball has a game on the 20th against Columbus North away, and Terre Haute North on the 22nd. Girls tennis has a match against Columbus North at home on Monday, and a match against Terre Haute North on the 22nd away. Boys track has an invite this Saturday against Ben Davis, and the whole track team has two more this next week against Columbus East on the 20th and Bedford North Lawrence on the 22nd. Good luck, athletes, in the upcoming weeks.
As we continue to keep COVID-19 in check, remember to continue being proactive. Practice social distancing in the hallways. Wash your hands and use hand sanitizer as often as possible, and make sure your mask is worn over your mouth and nose at all times. These simple procedures make a difference for yourself and each other.
The Hoosier Hills Horticulture Science students missed their annual garden plant sales last year, but this year they're already taking orders. We sent Eli to the greenhouse for details.
Hey, what's up? It's Eli Prather. I'm here at the Hoosier Hills greenhouse to talk about the plant sale. Hey, what's your name?
My name is Holly Grubb.
All right, Holly. How does it feel to be back in action after not having a garden sale last year?
I think it feels pretty great because last year we didn't have the chance to have all of these flowers or have a plant sale last year. But this year we're able to have all these plants and do the plant sale.
All right, thank you. Hi, what's your name?
Unique Bush.
All right. So how can we figure out more about this plant sale?
So you can come down here to the Hoosier Hills, talk to Katie if you'd like, Miss Frew. Our plant sale is May 6th, 7th, and 8th. On the 8th, it's a Saturday, so it's going to be 9 to 1. And we're just going to be selling plants all day here at the greenhouse.
Awesome. Thank you. Hey,
who are you?
I'm Shane Flick.
All right. What have you learned here that you've taken home to your home garden and applied?
Well, really, I just learned a lot of procedures on how to keep the plants alive, like how to make them flower a lot. We go around and we pinch the blooms off to make them bloom the right time. I learned about just the plants that I really want to plant, you know? Like, I get to see all of these, and I pick my favorite ones, and I get to plant them in my garden, and just really how to take care of them and water them right, and it really works good.
Hey, what's your name?
My name's Rhiannon Gerard.
What are you growing this year?
We grow a variety of things. We have flowers such as marigolds, we have different color petunias, we do different types of tomatoes like Beefmaster, sweets, lots of herbs as well. We have lots of basil and different types of things that you could need in your kitchen.
All right, sweet. Thank you. Hey, what's your name?
My name is Ben Allender.
And yours?
Abby Rudolph.
All right, Ben, well, what are we doing over here?
We're potting tomatoes right now.
All right. What's your favorite thing to do down here?
Probably move flowers because potting's not that fun.
All right. Thank you. Hi, who are you?
I'm Katie Frew, and I teach the ag classes here at Hoosier Hills.
All right. Where can we figure out more about the plant sale?
So you can go to our Facebook page, which we'll include down below, and find out more information. You can also find our pre-order forms there, and they're due April 30th. And we'd love to see you here at the plant sale May 6th through the 8th.
Thanks for watching. Make sure you check them out on their Facebook page. See you down here in a couple weeks.
Global Youth Service Day is the largest service event in the world, and you can register to join in. The Monroe County Youth Council, with support from the Youth Service Bureau of Monroe County and the City of Bloomington Volunteer Network, invites teens, Monroe County high schoolers, to upcoming hands-on day of service at Banneker Community Center. Projects will serve both environmental and food justice issues. The deadline to register is April 21st, and the participation is limited. You can send questions to the email on the screen. More details are provided in the description.
Deep Thoughts with Jamari Reeves.
You won't catch me dead on a bicycle.
This has been Deep Thoughts with Jamari Reeves.
This week's question of the week is, what do you do to help environmental sustainability? Here's what you said.
What do you do to help the environment?
Whenever I drink a soda pop, I always make sure to throw my can in the recycling.
The little things that count.
That's right.
One way that I help the environment is I use a reusable tote when I go to the grocery store, so I take it with me when I go. That way I'm using less plastic.
Well, I like to stay informed and pay attention in science class, so I know how to keep the environment safe.
All right, what's something you do to help the environment?
When I go out to eat or get drinks, I do not get straws.
So the ways I'm helping out the environment is that I have my own garden at home. We grow our own asparagus and tomatoes and onions and stuff like that. And then also, I am in charge of our family's recycling. So we recycle a lot. I live right next to a dump, so we bring it all over there all the time and do our best to make sure that all the cans and bottles and stuff are all recycled nicely.
My name's Nate Abdullah, and at our house, we recycle. And we have a garden, we grow some of our own food.
What is one way you personally help the environment?
I recycle my cans.
Well, I like to stay informed and pay attention in science class, so I know how to keep the environment safe and protect my generation from hurting the environment. And I also bring my own cup to fast food restaurants because that's just how informed I am and how safe I am.
What's something you do to help the environment?
I recycle.
What's something you do to help the environment?
I don't leave my house and I recycle.
We'll do so other people who can do stuff like making sure that bottles and plastics can go in the right recycling bins, and if you can also do it, maybe carpool lowers emissions in your cars, and also you can also ethically source stuff. So shipping things from around the world, from like vegetables and stuff, can be really costly and damaging the environment with emissions from transport and stuff. So growing stuff in your own gardens or sourcing it locally like you can here is super helpful for the environment.
What's something you do to help the environment?
Recently I bought Trader Joe's reusable grocery bags, so I don't have to use the plastic ones at the store. And those are pretty cool.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And now here with Howard's Hallway, where Mr. Howard takes a stroll with one of his fellow faculty members.
Hi everybody, welcome back to Howard's Hallway. We got another episode for you this time, and this time we are hanging out with Mrs. Venzel, who's gonna take a walk with us. So, Ms. Venzel, thank you for being here. Let's get it going.
All right.
So, tell me, Mrs. Venzel, where did you go to high school?
I went to Bloomington North.
Okay, Bloomington North grad. So I'm curious, because I think the first time I walked into Bloomington North was 2009. So what? How? I'm not gonna ask you when. What I am gonna ask you though is, what's the biggest change you've noticed from Bloomington High School North back whenever versus Bloomington High School North now?
Well, I graduated in 01, so it's really not that long ago, but we have done, there's such a renovation. So the construction was after I left. Lots of new things.
Very cool. Yeah. And tell me, what is your favorite place to visit on vacation?
Oh, my favorite place to vacation, I love to go to Palm Island in Florida. It's really nice. You ride a ferry over and all you can ride is a golf cart once you're there. So it's very nice.
Very cool. We're going to take a little pause right here, do some thumbs up, thumbs down.
All right.
And we're going to ask about water parks. How you feel about water parks?
Oh, that's not thumbs up.
Okay, thumbs up for water parks. How about ice fishing? Ice fishing, that's a big thing where I grew up, not as big here, but I'm curious.
I've never been, but I like to fish, so.
Okay, very cool. And last, we're gonna go with something that it's not really seasonal, but it comes up, candy corn.
Oh, no.
See, I'm a lover of candy corn, guys, but I'm finding I'm one of the few. Well, let's keep going and squeeze a few more questions in here.
Okay.
Tell me, what celebrity were you most likely to have, like, on a poster in your locker or up on your wall in high school?
Celebrity?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. gosh. I was a, 90210 place kind of fan, so probably one of those.
Probably one of the 90210 folks. Okay. And tell me, what classes do you teach here at Bloomington High School North for those of us who don't know?
It's family consumer science, so I teach nutrition and wellness. There's also child development, independent living, housing, fashion.
Okay.
Downstairs.
And what would you say? Yeah. What would you say is the coolest thing about the practical arts department at Bloomington High School North? Because I know a lot of kids maybe not, might not know about it.
Coolest thing is it's all hands on. You get to eat. Don't have to read a book and do your other studies, and it's a lot of fun.
Awesome. Well, hey, thanks for joining us, and thanks for watching, guys. And we'll catch you next time.
Thanks.
Hey there, I was just walking around, taking in sights, and I got to thinking about lunch through the days Friday, April 23rd, to Thursday, April 29th. For the 23rd, we're having chicken tenders, seasoned potato wedges, diced peaches, and Hartzell's rolled gold pretzels. Hey, what's this?
Uno!
Well, for Monday, April 26th, we'll have a personal pan cheese pizza, carrot snack, and berry juice. You don't see that every day. Anyway, for Tuesday the 27th, we'll enjoy a chicken filet sandwich or a spicy chicken filet sandwich, potato wedges, and a navel orange. Now what's going on?
Oh, this is gonna be good.
Kids these days, I tell ya. On Wednesday the 28th, grab yourself a beef taco, refried beans, Mexican rice, and some fiesta fruit punch. Whoa, hold on now. Should I tell somebody about this? On April 29th, let's eat a cheeseburger, some french fries, and a strawberry fruit cup. I would have given that done a perfect 10. Hey, I'll see you guys all in 2 weeks.
Hey, did you know that Hoosier Hills has its own greenhouse right here on campus?
I do now. That was super interesting.
And remember to respect yourself.
Respect each other.
Be responsible for your own actions.
And remember,
it's great to be a cougar.
Hi, I'm a baboon. I'm like a man, just less advanced.
Hey, family friendly, kid.
My bad.